to build upon the momentum of their best performance of the season. After beating UNCW 65-53, the Hens have another home game as they welcome the College of Charleston Cougars to town. Hi, everybody. I'm Matt Janis alongside Christine Coromata, Earl Holland back at our Newcastle studios. Christine, it was a complete performance by Delaware. They played a full 40. They did it on both ends of the floor. It's a tough act to follow up here this afternoon.
Great contributions. They play with great enthusiasm, a complete 40-minute game, and now they're hoping to build on that and have a repeat this afternoon.
Let's take a look at the starting lineups first for the College of Charleston. Cougars are 5-12 on the year. They are 1-5 in conference play, and they are led by a freshman point guard, Tyler Collins, one of the best in the country, averaging better than five dimes per game. McDonald's High School All-American nominee, also averaging 8 points per game, the freshman out of Atlanta, Georgia. She is joined in the backcourt by Darian Huff, the leading scorer for this Charleston club. 13 points, almost five rebounds per game, and she has started all but seven games over the course of her College of Charleston career. In the front court, Aaron Eady gets the start, 6'1 freshman out of Atlanta, Georgia. 6 points, 4.5 rebounds per game, earned her way into the starting lineup in conference play. Deja Ford, 13 points, 4 rebounds per game, 5'9 junior out of Waldorf, Maryland. And Bree Sullivan, 3 points, 4.5 boards per game. Sullivan, 6'1 senior out of Fredericksburg, Virginia. Candace Jackson in her fifth season as the head coach at the College of Charleston, assisted by Kelvin Long, Malika Willis, Brittany Parker, and Kyle Dillon. Meanwhile, the University of Delaware has the same starting lineup. We haven't been able to say that very often this season. Abby Gonzalez is the point guard, joined in the backcourt by Bailey Cargo. Simone DeFries is the small forward. She has been spectacular here over the last 2 weeks. DeFries coming off the best game of her Delaware career, 26 points and 11 rebounds in the win over UNCW. And in the front court, it's Lizzie O'Leary at power forward, the best screener on the team, according to head coach Natasha Adair, and Rebecca Lawrence, who averages 4 points, 3.5 rebounds per game. Head coach of the Hens, as I mentioned, Natasha Adair in her second season, assisted by Bob Clark, Sarah Jenkins, Michaela Walker, David White, and Adrian Eisenhower. Christine, as you look at this matchup, it's a tough one for Delaware to stay emotionally at the level they were on Friday. Certainly that'll be important. What are some of the other keys to look at this afternoon?
Well, I think one thing they did really well on Friday was ball movement. If they can reverse the basketball, they could penetrate those seams, not be stagnant in the offense. You know, they had 13 assists in that game as well. I think if they keep that ball movement, they'll get good open looks.
So that's on tap for Delaware today. The Hens in the home white jerseys, yellow script letters spelled Delaware across the chest, blue numbers on the front and backs of the jerseys, and a UD logo on the left and right legs of the shorts. College of Charleston in the maroon jerseys, yellow cap letters across the chest spell out Charleston with gold trim, yellow numbers, and yellow trim on the front and backs of the jerseys. And here we go. Rebecca Lawrence in the air. Delaware wins the tap as we are underway for the Bob Carpenter Center. Abby Gonzalez brings it into the forecourt for UD. Bounce pass left wing goes over to Simone DeFries. Dribbling towards the top against the zone for College of Charleston. 1-2-2 matchup. Bailey Cargo, left wing, cross-court feed back to Gonzalez, works her way to the free throw line. Near wing to Lawrence, deep two is good. Rebecca Lawrence shooting with confidence, gets Delaware on the board first.
And we always talk about her being able to pull bigs out in man-to-man, but even against the zone, it creates a different kind of shift for that front line.
Collins running point for Charleston, tried to attack, now backs it up against Delaware's 3-2 zone. Hens have it packed in a little bit. Now Cargo harassing Collins on the far wing into the corner. Huff open three off the mark. Long rebound grab by Lizzie O'Leary. Here comes Delaware looking to push. Gonzalez on the run. Finds DeFries. Nice move as she drives past the defense for the lefty lay-in.
Simone DeFries picking up where she left off on Friday. She went to the rim so great on Friday, and she's doing the same thing here today.
Attack the tin with reckless abandon. 4-0 Delaware leads. A 3-4 near wing short. Long rebound tipped by Cargo, batted by Gonzalez into the hands of DeFries. Here comes Delaware. The outlet up to Gonzalez. Spins her way. Collides with O'Leary, but gets it out to Cargo. Back to Gonzalez to set things up.
Another thing we saw on Friday was the decisions of when to run in transition, and Delaware getting some good transition baskets.
DeFries with it, foul out again, working towards the bucket, high off the window, she kisses it through.
You can just see the confidence that Simone DeFries is playing with.
Back-to-back drives, and Delaware's up 6-0. Collins the other way, far wing into the corner, right side forward, open three, twice off the rim, off the mark, out of bounds. And last touch by Breeze Sullivan, it goes to Delaware. And you can't draw up a much better start than this by the Hens.
Not at all. And their defensive action, active with their hands, they're rotating well and boxing out.
Full court pressure from College of Charleston. They had Gonzalez trapped, but instead of standing tall, they reached. They had a foul called on Deja Ford, and that's a big break for Delaware.
And right away you can see what the College of Charleston trying to do. They're trying to put on that pressure early, make it difficult for Delaware to get the ball up, so by the time they get into their offensive sets, a lot of time has gone off the shot clock.
They seem to surprise Delaware a little bit. They weren't set up in the press break. They are here, and over the top, the passes go. DeFries to O'Leary to Lawrence for a layup. It's 8-0, and Charleston takes a timeout 2 minutes into the game. What a start for the Hens. We'll take a break with College of Charleston. 8-0, Delaware leads. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV. Center in Newark, 8-0 is the lead. Delaware, 2 minutes into this game, forcing an early timeout from College of Charleston. And if there was any curiosity if Delaware could match the intensity they played with 2 days ago against UNCW, the answer is so far so good.
And when College of Charleston called that timeout, big smiles from the entire coaching staff of the University of Delaware. That's exactly what they planned for.
Charleston trying to attack out of their called timeout. Breeze Sullivan, though, turnaround jumper wouldn't go. Lizzie O'Leary the rebound. Long outlet forward to DeFries again to the lane. Can't get the roll, but does get the whistle. She is fouled and will head to the stripe for a pair. And how about the freeze? Not only continuing to attack the rim, but doing it on both sides, left and right hand.
And with her getting out in transition, what was the key to this play was Rebecca Lawrence clearing the path and almost boxing out, giving her somewhat of a lane and forcing the foul from Charleston.
DeFreeze connecting on the first free throw, 67% on the season. She'll get one more line right, and it's a 10-point Delaware lead as DeFreeze making both.
And now you see some pressure from Delaware trying to make College of Charleston earn getting onto their side of the floor.
7:35 and ticking left of the opening quarter. Along the far wing, Madison Taylor in for the first time. The freshman dribbles out near the center court stripe, works her way towards the near wing, picks up the bounce, feeds top of the key to Deja Ford. Ford, crossover move, works her way to the paint. Pull-up jumper, no good. Rebound batted and out to the perimeter. It's corralled by Taylor. Another try for College of Charleston.
Delaware had all the bodies in position, just could not grab the ball.
Hand check call against Lizzie O'Leary as Taylor tried to beat her baseline. And an early foul against O'Leary. That's been her one issue this year, just unable to stay on the floor due to foul trouble.
Yeah, and in there, it's hard because she was trying to close out, and then immediately the offensive player swinging through, going to the baseline, and Lizzie just not able to cut off that baseline in time after trying to close out.
7:04 to go, opening quarter. Far wing with it. Ford tried a lob entry, tipped away. Lawrence ends up with a steal. Here comes Delaware. Gonzalez feeds it forward to Cargo. Entry on the right block. O'Leary is bumped and is fouled by Erica Broughton. And the Hens will throw it in near baseline with 6:53 to go in the opening quarter. Up double digits already.
And that was great hustle by O'Leary, being able to shape up and establish position early in that possession.
DeFreeze gets it left wing to Cargo. Cargo dribbles towards the corner and has her pocket picked. Nice steal on the reach, Deja Ford. Ford across the timeline, angling towards the foul line, left elbow, works her way to the paint, got it blocked by Lawrence. The long arm strike again, long pass forward to DeFreeze, another lefty layup, no, Lawrence to follow, she had it blocked, and it's out of bounds, it'll stay with Delaware. A great defensive play, but you don't see Lawrence get her shot blocked on the offensive end very often.
Not very often at all, but we noticed on Friday too, Rebecca Lawrence just doing a great job of staying on her feet, keeping her hands up and doing the same there, not even needing really to jump, just being in good position.
She had three blocks in that game. Now an open layup off the inbound O'Leary, but a nice recovery. Edie got a big piece of the body, but got the ball up top, they say clean. And here comes College of Charleston the other way. Collins between the circles, left arm in air, calling out a play, works her way to the near wing, picks up her bounce, chest pass up top to Huff. She swings it right wing to Taylor. Into the corner, Broughton. Cross-court feed up top. Huff tried to leave it on the right block, but instead it's intercepted. DeFreeze jumping the passing lane. Another long outlet up to Cargo. Entry feed, right block, O'Leary spinning and banking it too strong. Edie, another rebound for Charleston. Here come the Cougars the other way. Collins into the corner. Huff head fakes a three. Drives into a double. Floats it top of the circle to Collins. Collins throws it away. DeFreeze and Cargo combining on the steal. Bailey on the run. Stop and pop of the foul line connects. And it's 12-0 Delaware.
Yeah, you talked about that early timeout and now these constant transitional movements and some players out there looking a little fatigued.
What a start. They are shutting College of Charleston out almost halfway through this opening quarter. A 12-0 advantage. Huff of the far wing. Up top, Collins. Collins works her way inside the arc. Now flares out to the right wing. Entry feed to Broughton on the right block. Powers up. No follow. Yes. Nice persistence. Erica Broughton, the redshirt freshman, gets Charleston on the board. Bailey Cargo running the floor, gets it in transition, baseline jumper, no, follows her miss and gets it back.
Delaware's just beating Charleston to every ball on the offensive end and defensive end.
Lauren's short corner for the other side, jumper short, and Taylor the rebound for College of Charleston. Taylor brings it up herself, 5'8 freshman out of Raleigh, up top to Huff, who floats it near corner. Collins drives into a double team, misses everything with a runner. Offensive board, though, follow good. Edie banks it in, and it's 12-4.
And both of those baskets, the last set and the set, have come from offensive rebounds for Charleston.
Hens looking a tad fatigued. They have three players over the scorers table waiting to check in. Lawrence for her first three of the season. No, a little short straight away. Long rebound, Huff outlets it on the run. Taylor got it blocked again. Lawrence saved it in right to Huff, though, and she lays it.
It really is amazing that all of their points are on second chance opportunities.
And Itache Dare not happy as Delaware trying to leak out off that shot block. Nobody went to get the basketball. And so she'll take a timeout here, I think twofold, trying to get the team recentered after Charleston responding with a 6-0 run. And it'd be get some fresh bodies in there. They look a little gassed.
They do. And Delaware doesn't run every time they get the ball, but there have been opportunities the last few times down that they've made those decisions to go in transition. But College of Charleston has as well. So, you know, you're going up and down and up and down. And this early in the game, definitely need to get a blow. The rotation up until the last couple sets has been on point for Delaware. And all of College of Charleston's last three baskets, that all 6 points, have come from second chance opportunities.
And almost all of them on the weak side,
yes,
too, which, I mean, that's one of the things in that zone. You've got to be very careful because if you attack the glass, so we hear the Delaware coaching staff talk about that all the time, that there are some chances for offensive boards. Paris McBride in for Delaware. Makeda Nicholas, Jasmine Dickey as well. McBride into the forecourt on the left wing. Feeds it far corner to Freeze. Back up top to McBride. McBride dribbles to the foul line. Finds Gonzalez, right wing three. Got it. Abby Gonzalez buries the triple. Delaware's up 9.
And that's what Paris McBride gives you when she comes in. It allows Abby Gonzalez to go off the ball. And boy, did that look good coming off her hand.
3:35 to go in the opening quarter. Near wing, it's Collins up top feeding to Ford. Ford swings it right wing to Huff. Huff gets it high post. A touch to Larson. Larson attacking off the dribble and lays it in high off the glass.
That was a really nice move by Larson and nice touch.
Kind of a spin and a nice floater that banked through. McBride up top, Gonzalez into the corner to Freeze. Head fake. Now a step back deep too short. Nicholas fighting for the offensive rebound, won the battle, goes up with a follow, twice off the rim, wouldn't fall, and the rebound corralled by Larson for Charleston. 15-8, Delaware's lead down to 7. They try to force it inside Broughton, pass was deflected, but right out to Collins. Collins gets it to Huff, open three right wing, no, Nicholas the rebound, outlets it up to McBride, 3-on-2 if they hurry. What a feed, McBride, finding DeFreeze for the layup. Oh, she threaded the needle with a one-hand bounce pass at a very difficult angle, and DeFreeze to the line for an and-one try.
There was not much room there, and the way she was able to lead her, and Simone, credit to her to go to the other side of the rim, maintain her body composure, and get that ball up and in.
That was as good a pass as we have seen all season, and DeFreeze converts at the stripe, the lead back to double digits. Here's Huff across the timeline. Nice catch on a high feed. Feeds it forward to Ford. Ford works her way to the paint and throws it off the leg of the hand out of bounds. It'll stay with College of Charleston. There's Bailey Cargo going to return. Abby Gonzalez sits down for Delaware.
And that was great rotation by Paris McBride. She had the assist down at one end and then getting on the weak side rotation, almost getting it fully but knocking it out of bounds. Great rotation on the weak side.
Taylor and Sullivan back in for College of Charleston. Ford sits down, as does Erica Broughton. Inbound comes baseline left. Tyler Collins gets it in. A crowd. Sullivan goes up with a shot. Wouldn't go. Rebound corralled in traffic by Nikita Nicholas. Outlets it up to McBride. McBride, shake and bake move. Works her way to the paint. Got it swatted. What a block by Bailey Larson. And then a tie-up as McBride hustled to the loose ball. But on held possession, arrow belongs to College of Charleston.
I really like the aggressiveness, but going into the trees there, no weak side rebounding, kind of all on your own, and giving up a lot of height on that early in the possession.
Hens try a trap in the backcourt. They float it over the top to Huff. Huff, her cross-court feed deflected and stolen away. Cargo leads perfectly to DeFreeze, dishes off to McBride, finds a trailing Nicholas, lobs it inside right block. Dickey banks it in. Not much spacing, but good passing, and hands her back up a dozen.
Great ball movement, but what made that was Jasmine Dickey's ability to gather herself, take her time, and go high off the glass.
That was like 50s basketball. Five passes all within 15 feet of the bucket. Far corner, an entry feed tried by Sullivan, stole it away. Dickey the deflection and the steal. Again, the hands on the run. McBride floats it, right block. Nicholas, turn and face, and a walk is called as she tried the head fake move. And a turnover gives it back to the Cougars.
And Delaware's defense is just so active. They're rotating, they have active hands, but College of Charleston is also making some bad passes. So you have to pass, if you're bounce passing it into the low post, away from the defense, and they're not doing those principal things and kind kind of giving the ball up and being a little sloppy with the basketball.
Telegraphing the feeds a little bit as well. Off the dribble, nice move here as a floater goes for Tyler Collins. Center of the lane, it's 20-10. McBride again just racing it the other direction. Finding Dickey. Dickey, one dribble, foul line, pull up, got stripped on the way up, but it bounces right to McBride. McBride dribbling to the near wing, handing it to Cargo. Feeds it top of the circle. Dickey swings it left wing to Defries. Into the corner, that side to McBride. Back up top to Defries. Eight to shoot. Simone works her way to the paint, got it blocked. Loose ball grabbed by Taylor. And here comes Cottage to Charleston. Ford on the run. Hesitation move. Works her way to the paint. And an arm bar called against the Hens.
You know, I know that that's a call, but I just don't like it in basketball in general. I think you have to be able to hold your ground, run with an offensive player as a defensive player, and you have to be able to guide. And the arm bar, you know, it used to be you can give a little arm bar as long as you're not having an open hand, and now they're really calling these arm bars. I just, personally, I don't like it.
That's why it's like with all sports, trying to legislate defense right out of it. The inbound lobbed out of bounds. I think that would have been Delaware's ball. Allison Lewis, though, good hustle, tried to chase it down, tipped it to the sideline.
And I don't think she realized. I think she thought it might have been tipped, but I think you're right. I think if that would have just been let out of bounds, it would have been Delaware basketball.
Second has to go off the shot clock if the ball was tipped in bounds, because they're going to throw it in on the far sideline or not. 47 and 4, 10 seconds to go, and the inbound goes top of the key to Collins. The officials went to the scorer's table, didn't change anything. Collins to the far wing, gives it off to Ford. Ford back up top to Collins, fake the pass right, drives the other direction, gets it now high post. Larson, turnaround jumper wouldn't go. Weak side rebound corralled again by Deja Ford, but then three Hens attacker on the deck. Tie her up, and the arrow back to Delaware. Oh, the Hens are swarming early.
And Delaware takes so much pride in their defense. This coaching staff takes pride in the defense, and that's what they want to see. Because as Natasha Adair always says, you don't have to be good at effort. You just give the effort, and they're showing it here today.
Yeah, she said there's a lot of X factors that go into every game. Effort should not be one of them. That should be a known quantity. Is Cargo over the top to Nicholas. Nicholas gives it into the corner to Lewis. Head fakes a jumper. Finds McBride as Delaware could hold for one. Good decision here. Lewis on the left wing driving towards the paint. Head fake got the defender in the air and then went up and was fouled. 9 seconds to go, but a trip to the free throw line for Allison Lewis.
Yeah, nice decision there. I think she went maybe a little early, but the fact that she was able to gather herself, just a little bit of a hesitation, shot fake, really intelligent basketball to get the defender up in the air. Charleston is trying to block a lot of shots. Delaware needs to give some shot fakes.
Lewis, line right, transfer out of Providence. Her 13th and 14th free throw attempts of the season connects with the first. So now 9 of 13 on the year, and the lead is 11 for Delaware. One more coming for Allison Lewis. And she's got that as well. 22-10, Delaware's lead. What a quarter from the Hens. They've had halves where they haven't sniffed 22 this year. Top of the circle, Collins works her way to the paint. Runner and too strong off the window. Nicholas clears the rebound, and that is the end of the opening period. Delaware all over Cottage of Charleston, leading 22-10 after one. Back with the second quarter in a moment. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV. in Newark as we get set for the start of the second quarter. It's a good first quarter as Delaware has played not just this season, but in a long time, up 22-10 on College of Charleston, stifling on both ends.
And they're in attack mode, and they're sharing the basketball, five team assists, but they are in attack mode. They've gone to the free throw line five times already, making all five free throws. They're moving the basketball. Their defense is fantastic. Not only the active hands, but the rotation. They're getting steals on the weak side. They have five steals in that quarter as well. Just phenomenal.
And they held College of Charleston to 5 of 19 shooting, almost all of them contested looks. Charleston ball moving right to left. They get it on the right block. Larson, cross-court feed near wing. Open three. Collins buries it. And it's 22-13.
And credit to Collins there, because that pass was at her feet, and she was able to pick it up off the ground and still maintain her shooting rhythm and knock that three down.
That's such a tough play. Lewis has it far corner, foot of the line, two, wouldn't go. Weak side rebound grabbed by Collins. Spins, brings it up across the timeline, near wing, into the corner. Finds Latrice Perkins for the pull-up jumper, and just like that, it's down to seven.
And you have to keep that aggressiveness up. Can't relax at all.
Gonzalez the other way for Delaware on the near wing. Up top, McBride. Floats it high post. Lawrence, turnaround jumper short. Offensive rebound tip, but grabbed on the other end by Huff for College of Charleston. Collins on the run. Stops, top of the key. Low bounce feed, right wing to Taylor. Taylor gives it corner to Perkins. Floats it up top to Collins. Collins backs it out near center court. Still 15 to shoot as she calls out a play. Now puts the fist in the air, calls out a different play. Gives to Perkins, right elbow feed to Sullivan, kicks it out, open three, Collins missed everything, and the rebound though tipped out of bounds. Shot clock reset, it should not have. That ball never hit the rim.
Yeah, I'm not sure if anybody has noticed that or not.
My miss, that didn't hit the rim, right?
I'm not sure.
Sure didn't seem like it.
It seemed like it went off to the side, but
thought it hit the backboard on the trail end, but nobody arguing, so I must have missed it. Inbound will come baseline right for Tyler Collins. Collins gets it in on the block and a tie-up, and the arrow belongs to Delaware, so it didn't matter. Took all of 2 seconds to create the turnover. Hens needed that one as Charleston had grabbed a little bit of momentum.
And again, you see Charleston picking up full court, kind of in a 1-2, 1-1 full court press right now, trying again to make it very difficult for Delaware. And Delaware on defense, although they're rotating, you don't feel that intensity that you felt in the first quarter.
Minute 20 in, the lead down to 7. Gonzalez floats it over the top to DeFries. DeFries works her way to the left wing, slows it up, finds McBride between the circles. Paris looks back at her head coach, Natasha Adair, who gives her the play, gets pawed at, but backs away from Taylor. Bounce pass top of the circle, DeFries. Left wing chest pass over to Gonzalez. Back to DeFries. Swing it near wing to McBride. Finding O'Leary in the corner. Back to McBride. Three to shoot. Somebody's going to have to hoist. And instead, DeFries is stripped. As she got it up top, Taylor took it away. Outlets it up to Collins, and she'll slow it up.
Yeah, you just don't have that same feeling. Delaware in that offensive set never had anything going.
Then a foul from behind as they get it high post. Asia Ford on the left elbow. And it looked like DeFries got a lot of ball, but they say a foul and a couple of free throws coming for Ford.
And she turned right away to the official and said that same thing. You're right, though. It did look like she just tipped the ball from behind, but getting called maybe for a little bit of hand as well.
So Ford, for a pair, hits the first 76% free throw shooter. Cargo in, Paris McBride out for Delaware. There's your Ford junior out of Waldorf, Maryland, having the best season of her career. Had two fantastic games earlier this season. Misses the second free throw. Back-to-back career highs, 22 and then 26 against App State. As DeFries length of the floor outlet, stripped on the way up, out of bounds. It'll stay with the Hens.
That was a great run, though, by Simone DeFries, getting wide in the lane. And Abby Gonzalez looking like a quarterback there, getting that ball the length of the floor.
And she kind of lulled the defense to sleep, was jogging, and then turned on another gear and blew past the safety man. Here's O'Leary in the high post, working her way to the paint. Powers up, wouldn't go. But O'Leary is fouled, and we'll head to the stripe for a pair.
And that was pure strength by Lizzie O'Leary. She got good position, but the way she was able to turn her body and keep strong with the ball while keeping it high, and her upper body strength allowed her to just still get that ball off and almost had a chance to go in.
So O'Leary will shoot two. First free throw, a high arcer. Back rim no good. O'Leary, 5 of 11 on the season from the stripe. Was a very good free throw shooter last year. She actually seems to have a little bit better touch the further away from the basket she goes. I think some of that is because she gets beat on so much inside that, you know, she's having to use a little extra strength just to get the shot up. There's a little miscommunication on the substitution. They do let Broughton in. Second free throw gets the roll. And it's 23-16. Beg your pardon, 22-16. Far wing on the bounce, it's Collins. Collins, no, it is 23-16. Scoreboard just a little late to adjust. They get it high post, Broughton. It's tipped away from her. O'Leary ends up with a steal. Here comes Delaware the other way. Gonzalez feeds O'Leary. Foot of the line, two, short. Quick shot, and Broughton pulls down the rebound.
Yeah, not so sure. I thought she was going to seal what you said, that she shoots a little bit better the further back she is. But I think early in the shot clock, but Natasha Adair, she wants her team to shoot. They all have green lights to shoot the basketball.
Oh, don't you worry. I was going to beat you to that. I had Claire Voigt all ready to go. Broughton on the near block. It's at high post. Getting away with a walk is Larson, and she finishes in the lane. It's 23-18.
You only said that just so you could say your word clairvoyant anyway. English major.
Gonzalez, top of the circle for Delaware. Hens really need a bucket here. Instead, an errant pass. Good hustle. Lawrence dove in and undercut. Madison Taylor is going to be called for a foul as a result. That's a first on Lawrence. First on Delaware in the second quarter, but right now all of the momentum belongs to College of Charleston. Once down nine to within five and with the ball.
Yeah, they're matching Delaware's intensity from that first quarter. But, you know, getting back to you using big words, you know, Delaware broadcaster of the year and Mary Wary, the ultimate Blue Hen fan, made a sign for you here today in the crowd, Matt. And even the one official came over and said, "Are you Matt? Are you the Delaware broadcaster of the year?" And she wanted to meet you.
I tell you, I'm going to make Mary Wary my agent. As nice a lady as you will find, though. Entry fee, Taylor had it kicked away. It'll stay with College of Charleston. 6:35 to go first half, 23-18, the lead for Delaware.
I mean, I don't know if I've ever seen broadcasters have signs in the stands. Matt, you've reached a new level, my friend.
Oh, my. Here we go. All right. The inbound goes to Broughton on the block. Broughton is bumped and fouled, and all of a sudden, the officials seem to be getting paid by the call.
It is interesting. Now, although in the first quarter, I mean, there were so many transition runs, quick baskets. The game was really at a fast pace, and now things have slowed down a little bit, a lot more in the half-court set.
Inbound comes near corner. Perkins floats it top of the key to Taylor. Taylor back near wing, finds Hoff, open three. Back rim, no. That looked good off her hand. What a rebound, though. Pulled down by Perkins for another try. Perkins on the near wing. Fakes a feed. Now cross-court feed, right wing over to Taylor. Taylor back to Perkins. Gets it high post. Broughton scoops it up. No. Follow Perkins. Missed that. DeFreeze clears the rebound for Delaware.
Perkins so active on that possession. I mean, when you talk about that rebound, she got so high there. I thought she was going to finish it off with that layup.
DeFreeze deep two just inside the arc. Would not go. Rebound grabbed by Collins. Outlets it up. Perkins on the run. And a blocking foul as Cargo tried to get back to take the charge. And it was just a half step slow.
And you hear it a little bit from the Bob Carpenter Center faithful. I think they thought she did a good job of kind of beating her to the spot, but she was still kind of moving to the side and almost like swiping through. She would have established her feet a little bit and then been able to jump straight up. That's the difference there.
First free throw is good. Perkins has really provided a lift off the bench. This freshman class for College of Charleston can play.
They really can, and when you mix some of those youngsters with the likes of Deja Ford, who has just been improving steadily each year, you know, they could be a dangerous team.
Tried to get Maddox in. I guess she realized she was coming in for the shooter, so she walked on the floor and then had to go back. Second free throw is good, and that's what it is, as Perkins will depart, which is a little bit surprising because she has provided a real punch for College of Charleston. They're within three.
Yeah, I would have kept her in and rode her until halftime.
Well, Bailey Cargo almost passed the ball to Rebecca Lawrence as she was standing out of bounds. She's stuck on the baseline. They have two to get it across. What a feed. Gonzalez just across the midcourt stripe with a half second to spare.
And I think the difference has been so far in the second quarter is the shot selection for Delaware. Choosing to shoot the long ball a little bit more, not getting it as inside as many times.
And now an entry feed, Lawrence on cue from the left block, banks it in.
That's because I'm sitting next to the sportscaster of the year.
Oh, my goodness.
That's why.
I was on cue
with that. I mean, you're rubbing off on me, Matt. This is great.
Clairvoyant. That's what you were. 5:29 to go first half. Delaware 25. College of Charleston 20. Collins walks it across the timeline for the Cougars. Feed stop to Nikita Huff. Back to Collins. Collins gets it into the corner. Taylor. Taylor back to Collins again. Collins dribbling to the far wing. Feeds it high. Puts the bobble. Maddox corrals it, and she walked. It was off from the start once she didn't catch it clean. And a ball back to Delaware, up 5, 5-12 to go first half.
Yeah, definitely the right idea there by Maddox to turn, just took that extra little shuffle.
And she will sit down. And right back into the ballgame comes Perkins. Full court pressure, Gonzalez beats it almost single-handedly, works her way into the forecourt, stops between the circles, angles to the near wing, finds DeFries up top, pull up at the foul line, she is fouled. Boy, College of Charleston doesn't get cheated. When they go for blocks, they come swiping down with those arms, and they got a big rake on Simone. DeFries will be at the line when we return. Timeout on the floor, 5 minutes to go in the first half. Delaware up five, the lead College of Charleston, 25-20. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball.
The rule of three states, things that come in threes are inherently more appealing than those that don't. We couldn't agree more. Three SUVs, one GMC. Ring in the new year with a new GMC. Get 19% below MSRP on these select models in stock. We are professional grade GMC.
Oh, say can you see?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
The free throw line tried to extend that advantage for the Hens. And the first free throw for the junior is good. DeFries, Bergenfield, New Jersey native, first into double figures today. She's got 10. Second free throw good. Both swishes. And that'll give you an indication of how much confidence DeFries has right now.
Well, she's had such a great weekend. I mean, this is some of the best basketball she's played all year.
Charleston breaks some pressure by Delaware. Down seven with the ball. They get it high post. Broughton attacking. Got it blocked by Dickey. Got it back. Missed everything. Perkins a third try. And this time she's fouled. And then Broughton shoves Dickey afterwards. That was interesting. And it'll be a trip to the free throw line for Latrice Perkins, who's playing a whale of a second quarter.
And I'm not sure if the coaching staff saw that, because if that was me, I would have asked to go to the monitor for that one, because that was high. It was above the shoulders.
Looking at the replay, it looked like maybe Broughton stumbled on the basketball, okay. And that's why she gave a little extra, for sure. But I think maybe she tripped over the basketball and lost her balance just a little bit. Nice shot by the Hens All Access crew. Is Rebecca Lawrence going to come in? Perkins hitting the first free throw. DeFries sits down because that was foul number two. It's a big one on Delaware.
It really is, because she's been the majority of the offense thus far this afternoon. But you can't say enough about Latrice Perkins, not all in the stat book, but the way she's really just infused herself, especially on the defensive end. I think she's done a really nice job.
Energy, long arms, and also has attacked the offensive glass as well. She hits both free throws, sits down again, and a lead back down to 5 for Delaware.
Interesting, because Candace Jackson keeps pulling her in and out. It's just an interesting substitution.
And Delaware breaks some pressure. Nicholas gets it across the timeline. Hands it to Gonzalez, 18 of the timer, as the Hens get into the offense. Gonzalez dribbling to the near wing, up top feeding Dickens. Dickens back to Gonzalez. Gonzalez into the corner. Lawrence up top finding Dickey. Dickey lobs it high post. Nicholas, 3 to shoot. Fadeaway jumper, got it. Not the prettiest of possessions, but a beautiful result.
Yeah, Nicholas really saving that offensive set there. And she's, you know, that's a typical shopper. She can shoot the fadeaway.
And she can do it at the apex or on the descent of the jump, which certainly helps as well. Pops near corner, floats it up top to Collins. Collins jabs right now, comes left, gives it near wing Taylor. Taylor into the corner, Huff floats it, left block Larson. Turnaround jumper got deflected. Dickey tipped it to Gonzalez, who tried to bounce it back to Dickey. Instead, Collins comes in and gets the loose ball.
Well, that went through about 6 different players there.
Nicholas tips the pass away, stolen by Gonzalez. 2-on-1 with Dickey, gets the feed and lays it home. Textbook break for Delaware.
That really did look like a 2-on-1 drill there, and great running of the wide lane again by Dickey, and great court awareness by Gonzalez.
31-22, the Hens up 9. 3:13 to go in this opening half. Huff on the far wing, dribbles towards the top, feeds it to Collins, who gets it near wing to Taylor. Back to Collins. Collins dribbles inside the arc, low feed, bobbled grab by Taylor, has to give it back to Collins. 4 to shoot, gives it to Taylor. Open 3, long, weak side rebound, cargo for Delaware. Outlets it up to Gonzalez again, looking to push, finds Dickey in the corner, and Dickey slows it up, getting it back to Gonzalez. 2:42 left first half. Delaware up 9 with the ball. Dickey near corner. Works her way along the baseline. Stops at the block. Nice feed opposite corner. Cargo can't hit the 3. And Larson grabs the rebound.
That really was a great pass. Good awareness there by Dickey. This has been a nice response by the Hens.
Pretty good feed from Collins as she whipped it inside to Taylor. And Taylor is fouled and will head to the line for 2. But he really feels like a different College of Charleston team right now. I haven't seen enough of Charleston to be able to give a big picture view of this, but when Perkins is in the game, their offense, I mean, they have some second chances. It flows a little bit better, and the defensive rotation is sharp, and they keep yo-yoing her in and out. As the first free throw, Taylor hits it.
Yeah, it is really interesting because it's not visible. You know, every team has their own concepts and philosophies, but it's not visibly that it seems like she's making mistakes, but she's constantly coming in and out. And for a player, it's hard to really get into a rhythm when you're being pulled in and out of a basketball game.
Second free throw in and out, so 1 of 2. The lead 8 for Delaware as O'Leary grabs the rebound. McBride comes in for the end. She dribbles into the forecourt running point. Stops on the near wing, works her way inside the arc, backs up beyond the 3-point line. Now towards the top of the key, a lot of contact. Perkins kind of tripped her, and then on help, they give the foul to Taylor, which was probably the least contact of any on that possession.
Yeah, a little too much dribbling there. You got to move the basketball a little bit. I understand the initial, you know, penetrate the scene, got to reverse that basketball. Delaware got bailed out a little bit by the foul by Taylor, but got to move that basketball.
And Brown comes to McBride right in the UD logo. McBride works her way to the paint, scoops it up and through off the window. What a take by Paris McBride.
And that was something we saw her do really well on Friday, was get to the rim, cut through that defense, and lay it up and finish.
She just gets so small. She kind of goes underneath the defense on the rotation. Here's Broughton in the high post, gets it far corner to Huff. Huff cross-court feed was coming our way, but Taylor comes over to catch it. Taylor, near wing, gets it inside, left block Larson, and her pass was deflected out of bounds. It was grabbed by Perkins, but after it had hit the sideline, so it'll stay with Charleston. 5 to shoot, Delaware up 10, 1:36 to go first half.
Again, Lawrence has been doing a great job the last few games of just holding her position, and she has long arms, so she's able to block those shots without jumping. And again, Perkins goes out of the basketball game. I'm really not understanding the substitution pattern at all.
Perkins, freshman, getting coached up by Jackson. The inbound Huff gets it to Broughton, right back to Huff. Right wing Taylor, open three, off the mark. Nice board by Lawrence. Boxing out, holding her ground to grab it. Outlets it up to McBride. She's always looking to push, but a good decision to slow it up. High screen comes from O'Leary, turns the corner off of it. Tried to feed it to Cargo, curling off the screen. Couldn't get the shot off. Back to McBride on the right wing. Entry feed for O'Leary. She's being held. And a foul on Aaron Eady with 1:14 left. And College of Charleston's over the limit. So free throws coming for Lizzie O'Leary.
And here's where, you know, especially for Paris McBride in general, but as a young point guard, understanding the game situation, 1:14 left, your team currently up 10, potentially going to go up 12 here, where you want to use the shot clock on the next possession, get a stop, but then use that shot clock and see what you need to do.
First free throw good for O'Leary. 34-23, 1:14, as you mentioned, to go. Returning into the ballgame, Bree Sullivan, as Eady will sit down. Second free throw good. 35-23, Delaware's lead is a dozen. Taylor into the forecourt for College of Charleston. Near wing give to Ford. Cross court back to Taylor. Into the corner they find Huff. Huff dribbles towards the top. Feeds it off to Ford. Ford cross court feed Huff. Quick release three from the corner, got it. Boy, that left her hands in a blink of an eye, and it's 35-26. McBride races it into the forecourt, hits the trailing Lawrence. Back to McBride out between the circles. Hands it right wing Cargo, cross court feed Lawrence, open three, and that one wouldn't go. Offensive rebound tip by Dickey, but off the hands of O'Leary and grabbed by Ford. Ford brings it up, 5 second differential shot and game clock. Huff in the corner, gives it high post to Ford. Ford doubled, had it knocked free, got it back, gets it out to Taylor. Still 14 to shoot. Taylor dribbling, foul line right now, backs it out to the wing. Hands it to Huff, 6 to shoot. Huff, near wing, giving to Ford. Into the corner, Broughton back to Huff, 1 to shoot, and throws it up at the buzzer, gets it to go. And then a whistle. I don't know why, but it's a great whistle for Delaware. 3.6 seconds to go. They're going to go check and see whether that was good. What a great break for the Hens. They weren't going to get another shot off. Instead, they're going to get to draw up an inbounds play here in the backcourt with 3.6 seconds to go. It was close. I didn't think Huff was going to be able to get it off, but then I kind of think she did.
Yeah, looking at it live, it seemed like she got it off in time, and I was just thinking to myself, too, before she hit the three in the corner on the possession before that, you know, they had been doing a good job on her,
yeah,
but
scored.
It's all, yeah, it was, she had 2 points, and then it was only a matter of time for her to start getting going. So she hits that. That would be her 7th point. But I thought I did live. It looked like she got the shot off.
So the officials over to the monitor to check it out. 3.6 seconds to go. Reminder, Earl Holland comes your way next for the halftime report. He'll look back at Delaware men's win over Drexel yesterday. What a wild game that was. Hens were in complete control, got very exciting, more exciting than Martin Ingles being company would have liked down the stretch. But Delaware holding on for the 1 point win over their rival. This is what you got to fix, by the way. Two officials look, they bring in a third official to look, then they'll confer, committee meeting, they'll go talk to both coaches. The delays on these reviews take too long.
I agree wholeheartedly. It's like life. You have all these meetings, and then you have to have meetings with the subcommittee meetings. When the meetings, everybody just gets together at the meetings to tell you what they did in the meetings.
It should be, unless you're in the last 2 minutes of the game, if you don't look at it and see definitively right away, it should just stay. You should get like 20 seconds max to fix it.
Yeah, agreed. You know, getting back to the men's win over Drexel yesterday, also pretty exciting was the baby race was yesterday at halftime. Very exciting, some of the athletic staff, young ones in that race. And credit to Brendan Fuller and Ryan, their son Kian, blew the competition away.
Hey, they waved off the shot. Good
break
for Delaware.
I need glasses.
35-26. We both thought it was good. The buzzer never sounded. I think that's what threw us off a little bit. So the inbound comes for the Hens. They had a chance to draw up a play under their own basket. Lawrence gets it into Cargo. She's got a little space, but throws it up at three-quarter court. It lands before the clock expires, and that is the end of the opening half. Still a good one, though, for Delaware, up 9 at intermission.
I thought the response in that second quarter when it got really tight, they responded yet again. In the initial first quarter, they responded just by starting out really well, 10-0. Then they got down, it got cut to 3, and what they responded again. Really good quarter.
Halftime at the Bob, Delaware 35, Cottage of Charleston 26. Earl Holland on the other side of this break. He'll have a halftime report when we return.
The rule of threes states, things that come in threes are inherently more appealing than those that don't. We couldn't agree more. Three SUVs, one GMC. Ring in the new year with a new GMC. Get 19% below MSRP on these select models in stock. We are professional grade GMC. Three states, things that come in threes are inherently more appealing than those that don't. We couldn't agree more. Three SUVs, one GMC. Ring in the new year with a new GMC. Get 19% below MSRP on these select models in stock. We are professional grade GMC.
Say, can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get 6 numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
The rule of three states, things that come in threes are inherently more appealing than those that don't. We couldn't agree more. Three SUVs, one GMC. Ring in the new year with a new GMC. Get 19% below MSRP on these select models in stock. We are professional grade GMC.
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Three states, things that come in threes are inherently more appealing than those that don't. We couldn't agree more. Three SUVs, one GMC. Ring in the new year with a new GMC. Get 19% below MSRP on these select models in stock. We are professional grade GMC.
6, Delaware leading College of Charleston. I'm Matt Janis with Christine Coromana. Earl Holland, nice job back in our Newcastle studios. Joined in a moment by the associate head coach of the Hens, Bob Clark. Delaware in the first half as a team, 41% for the floor. Maybe more importantly, they held College of Charleston to just 28% shooting. And as we welcome in Coach Clark, you know, you came out with great intensity there to start the basketball game. That was an incredible first quarter, 22 points. Tough stretch to start the second. Had to be proud of the way your team bounced back there close to first half.
Yeah, Matt, we know who we're playing. And, I think we brought them off by a little bit by pushing the ball up. A couple turnovers. We're a victim of our own successes. We got a little lackadaisical. They're not going to quit. We just got to keep playing our part of the basketball this season.
Yeah, and obviously you know many of these players very well. The juniors and seniors were many of the young ladies that you recruited when you were down at Charleston. I know it helps with the scout, but how does that come into play for you guys?
Well, I think you have to ask them. They probably play a little harder. They want to show a good front. You shouldn't have left, but I don't know. They're a good team. Their freshmen give them a lot of burst of energy. 23 and 15 are freshmen. Number three is a freshman. She came in and got a big overload. They've got 8 points off offensive rebounds, and that's on us. There's no way they should be
out. Is it just a hustle thing on the offensive glass? Because they did do a nice job there on the weak side.
Yeah, it is a hustle thing. We've talked about the weak side. You have to account for everybody. Sometimes we get caught watching the ball and we don't see who's going to do something. We talked about it. We got to clean it up a little bit, and hopefully we'll be fine.
Last thing, Simone DeFries, another big first half for you guys. She got into foul trouble. Were you pleased with the way everybody else was able to kind of step up and she had to sit down?
Absolutely. Simone's playing well. She's running the floor. Abby's pushing the ball. And that's when we're at our best. We get some easy transition baskets. And Simone usually has something to do with that.
Good luck, second half, Coach. Bob Clark, associate head coach of the Hens. His team is up by 9 at the break and trying to grow that advantage. And Christine, when you look at the first half stats, I think CC stole mine, but what stands out for you over the first 20 minutes?
Well, I think the biggest thing was, you know, the burst that they had in the first quarter was phenomenal. It is hard to keep that level up, and you know every team's going to make runs. But what really stood out to me was the response in the end of the second quarter. They could have easily let this get into a really tight game, but they responded. But I think the biggest adjustment that this Delaware team needs to make is on the defensive glass. Charleston got 6 offensive rebounds in that second quarter. They had 5 offensive rebounds in the first quarter, so 11 offensive rebounds at halftime. That's a little too many. They got to clean that up.
Delaware started the game on a 12-0 run. Since then, it's been virtually even. And as a result, Delaware up by 9 at the break. When you look back at how that first half unfolded, they really ran College of Charleston into the ground in that first quarter. Give credit to the Cougars. I think they adjusted, but how did they get that transition game going again?
For Charleston, I think they just need to keep pushing. I think Collins did a really nice job of getting the ball out, but the reason was they were able to make stops. Delaware did such a good job offensively in the first quarter that Charleston couldn't get the ball and run in transition. In the second quarter, they started to get some stops, and then they were able to get the ball out in transition.
So it'll be College of Charleston ball to start the second half. Cougars moving from left to right, and we are underway. Delaware in the home white jerseys, the 3-2 zone, and it's Taylor on the far wing, giving it up top to Collins. Collins works her way towards the paint, kicks it out to Ford straight away. 3 is good, just like that. We've got a 6-point game.
Yeah, really tough way to start there because you have to have that rotation got caught a little bit too low there on the top.
So now Delaware needs an answer. Lawrence giving it near wing to Fries back out there into the corner. Left side, Daly Cargo. Bounce pass all the way to the top of the circle to Fries. Turns the corner right of the lane. Kicks it out to Gonzalez. Gonzalez drives. Dishes up top to O'Leary. Back to Gonzalez near corner. Floats it for Cargo. It's tipped out near center court. 4 to shoot. Lawrence has it. Has to heave a 30-footer. Misses everything. And that's a shot clock violation. Give College of Charleston credit. They were swarming on that trip by the Hens.
And, you know, the all these college basketball teams do a great job of making adjustments at halftime. So just as CC was sitting here telling us about the adjustments they made, you know that Charleston's going in and making adjustments as well. And you can already see it on the defensive end.
Tough wide open. Buries the three. The Hens slow on the rotation. And we've got a three-point game. And Delaware has to take a timeout 1 minute into the third quarter. So six straight by the Cougars. It's 35-32. We'll take the break with Delaware. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
The rule of three states, things that come in threes are inherently more appealing than those that don't. We couldn't agree more. Three SUVs, one GMC. Ring in the new year with a new GMC. Get 19% below MSRP on these select models in stock. We are professional grade. GMC.
Oh, say can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
One minute into the start of the second half, College of Charleston has taken what was a nine-point deficit, trimmed it to three, and forced Delaware to take an early TO.
Kind of exactly the opposite of how the game started. Delaware ran out on a 10-0 start. Charleston took a timeout 2 minutes into the game.
Here come the Hens as they break some pressure, but then trapped to the forecourt. Bailey Cargo, she's stripped. Headman passed to Huff. Runner wouldn't go. And Gonzalez hustles back to grab the rebound. Then she's stripped. Huff hustling for the loose ball, and Charleston ends up with it. And the Hens getting out hustled right now. Huff for three. Front rim twice. No offensive board. Good. Aaron Eady bringing the Cougars to within one.
And you see College of Charleston just playing with unbelievable intensity right now. They have all the momentum and intensity on their side.
Gonzalez, big three, left wing, missed. Grazed the front of the rim, out of bounds to Charleston. Eight in a row by the Cougars to start the third quarter in under 100 seconds.
We talked a lot about that second quarter and how Charleston made a run, but then Delaware was able to respond, and that's what we need to see right now.
All right, Charleston bringing it into the forecourt. Collins across the timeline, giving it near wing Taylor. Back to Collins, into the corner, Huff. Huff back up top, Collins. Dribbling, top of the key, giving it left wing to Ford. Ford bluffs a pass left, now gives it back out between the circles to Collins. Collins attacking off the bounce, walked. Good rotation as both Nicholas and DeFries were there to force the travel.
Yeah, that was really good sliding of her feet there to beat her to the spot, and Collins a little bit out of control.
7:58 left third quarter. Delaware's lead down to one. They've led the entire way. O'Leary dishes off to Gonzalez. Feeds it to Paris McBride, who just checked in, and she'll get everybody organized. Left wing feed to O'Leary. Hands it there to DeFries. Bounce pass up top, Nicholas. Last standing around right now for Delaware. McBride gets it in the corner. Hits the three. Paris McBride, only her fourth made three of the season.
Well, that'll make her an absolute perimeter offensive threat by Charleston. They're going to have to come out and play her there now that she's proven to them she can knock down that shot.
4 of 28 now on the year. Here's Hoff, high post, give to Ford. Ford driving through a double, lays it in. Split. Two defenders at the foul line, and it's 38-36.
Wow. That was a great move and switch to the left hand there. And you have to think she must have some family, you know, in the building being from Maryland.
Lob, left block, Nicholas, turnaround, jumper short. Offensive rebound, DeFries had it knocked out of her hands by Edie. It'll stay with Delaware.
That was a great crash by DeFries and kept that ball alive for the Hens.
6:58 to go. We're in the third. Delaware was up 9 at the half, led by as many as 14 in the first half. Down to a two-point advantage now. Gonzalez gets it right blocked to Nicholas. Backing down the defender. Up and under move. Banks it too strong. Rebound batted loose and grabbed by Edie for College of Charleston. Dishes it off on the run. Collins. Collins works her way inside the arc. Kicks it out to Hoff. Back to Collins. Corner three. Got it. And Charleston has its first lead of the game.
That was great two-man basketball by Collins and Huff. A little bit of two-man game, moving without the basketball. They got to know where they are at all times.
Now Delaware looks completely stunned right now. McBride near corner from O'Leary. Dribbles towards the baseline. Now floats it to DeFries. DeFries attacking. Bounce pass to Nicholas. Nicholas lobs it back to DeFries. Got it blocked by a flat-footed Ford who outlets it up to Huff. 2-on-3, Huff wants to attack anyway. Got stripped by McBride, out of bounds. It'll stay with College of Charleston.
And right now, Charleston just looks more enthusiastic. They look more intense, and Delaware trying to figure it out, but they need to try to get some stops on the defensive end to create some of that offense.
Inbound going to come from Taylor as O'Leary goes out, and Dickey comes in. Maybe that'll provide a little bit of an offensive spark. They lob it right block to Edie. Edie backing down Nicholas, spinning, hit the front rim. Good defense as Bakeda grabs the rebound. Hands the outlet to McBride. What a feed ahead of the pack to DeFries, and she got hammered and came down awkwardly. You could hear the surprise and the concern from the Bob Carpenter Center faithful, but DeFries is able to get up and walk and seems to be all right. A very awkward collision.
Oh, my goodness. She just landed on top of her. She was already on the ground and just basically pancaked her, as my youngest son would say. Pancaked her there, but the slam and the noise. Oh, my goodness.
And it was that left arm. That seems to be what Simone is looking at, but seems to be all right. The inbound goes to Gonzalez. Hens down one with the basketball. 5 3/4 left of the third period. Dickey on the near wing. Hands it there to DeFries. A jab step. Gives up top Nicholas. Lobs inside. Dickey lays it in. Center of the lane. Finishing with the right hand. Hens back up one. Charleston looking to attack. Collins all the way. Kicks it out left wing to Taylor. Back to Collins. Another corner three. That one no good. Gonzalez tips the rebound to DeFries. Now Delaware looks to run as two College of Charleston players fall down. Gonzalez right wing three, got it. Abby Gonzalez, the transition triple. Delaware back up four.
This pace has really picked up here.
They were falling like bowling pins behind the play. Delaware saw it and took advantage. Collins on the near wing. Dribbling inside the arc, works her way to the right block, can't finish with the right hand. DeFries the rebound, outlets it up to McBride. Paris works her way to the paint, pulls up, now attacks again, banks it too strong, rebound comes right to her, and she dribbles out of traffic out to set things up.
Love the stutter step there by McBride to change acceleration.
Now she changes pace again, but draws into a charge, offensive foul, as she barreled into the chest of Deja Ford.
Yeah, I don't think so. I think she was in the restricted area. It was pretty clear. She was in the restricted area. Yeah.
Now they change it. Blocking call. Good eyes, Christine, as the officials confer. Two free throws coming.
I didn't think there was any doubt. I thought her feet were set. I mean, I wasn't sure if it was a charge even without her feet being set, but I thought her feet were set in the restricted area.
Did the basket go in?
It did.
It did. So an and one coming for Paris. McBride ends up 6. 4:41 to go in the third. We'll be back with more Blue Hens women's basketball on Fox Sports 1290 at 1410 WDOV.
The rule of three states, things that come in threes are inherently more appealing than those that don't. We couldn't agree more. Three SUVs, one GMC.
Ring in the new year with a new GMC. Get 19% below MSRP on these select models in stock. We are professional grade. GMC.
Carpenter is set, what a move. Paris McBride pulling the string as she went back and forward and accelerated into a defender set up in the restricted area for an and one to give Delaware a 6-point lead with a free throw coming. 4:41 left in the third quarter. McBride, the true freshman, cannot convert as she missed the foul shot. Gonzalez tipped the rebound off the fingertips of Latrice Perkins. It stays with Delaware.
This really has been a back and forth game as far as momentum and urgency, and right now Delaware is getting the swing again.
It is on the seesaw. Entry feed on the inbound. Nicholas got bumped and fouled. Couldn't get the roll, but he'll head to the stripe for a pair. If it was a seesaw, I'd be worried about the springs right now. It's going back and forth so often.
So metaphorical. My goodness. But I'll tell you what, Delaware is having their way on the inside right now. They're taking their time with their post moves. Their footwork's good. And Charleston has been getting caught in the trap of trying to block shots instead of staying firm with their foundation.
So first one good, one more coming for Nicholas. And she's got it. 9 straight points from Delaware after they went down by 1. They're up 8.
Man, you don't usually see Delaware, you know, beating other teams in fast break points, but right now they're beating Charleston 12-2.
And a near steal. Hens think they got it on the deflection. They thought it went out of bounds off of Taylor. No, says the official. It stays with Charleston. Boy, the emotions back for Delaware after they were flat to start the second half.
Yeah, and I think Jasmine Dickey has made a difference here on the defensive end as well.
Inbound goes to Collins, up top to Perkins. Swing it near wing, Taylor. Taylor dribbling towards the top between the circles to Collins. Works her way to the foul line. Pull-up jumper. Back rim, no. Good rebound on cue from Dickey. Outlets it up to Paris McBride. A freshman gives it back to her fellow freshman. Dickey all the way to the bucket and a foul. Late whistle, but a foul as contact came from Bailey Larson and another trip to the stripe for UD.
And even though the whistle was late, it was the correct call because there was a ton of contact. She released the basketball and basically got smacked right in the head there. And you'll see she comes down all the way, a lot of contact.
I always find that a tad frustrating when the officials wait to see whether it goes in before they make the call. But as you said, they got it right. And Dickey, line left, 4-2. First one is up and good. 48-39, 4:07 to go in the third. Broughton comes back. I thought Broughton gave good minutes for College of Charleston in that first half as well.
Yeah, she's done a nice job, especially on the defensive end.
And that's right now what the Cougars need is Delaware scoring at will. Second free throw good. The lead is up to 10.
And that's the other thing we've seen this weekend. Delaware putting a lot of points up on the board.
And a press of the backcourt. They throw it over the top to Huff. Huff gives it to Collins. Under 4 to go in the third quarter. Collins had her pass deflected, but it bounces to Huff. Huff gives it over to Taylor. Taylor back to Collins between the circles, 11 to shoot. Collins, hesitation, gives it to Huff, floats it for Broughton. It's tipped away from her by Dickey, right to Gonzalez. Lob feed forward to DeFries, and she is fouled by Huff. DeFries was trying to leave it off. Charleston's over the limit. Simone is headed to the stripe.
And I thought that was a little extra passing by Simone. She may not have felt that she could get that shot off, and if that's the case, then it's the right foul. But definitely Huff tried to beat her to the spot, but you know, she's arguing the foul. She doesn't understand.
Well, that was a kind of a tough call to go against Collins Charleston because, as you said, DeFries was sort of falling on her own. Can't get the roll of the first. I wonder if she was stuck under the rim, and that's why she tried to throw that pass.
I think that's exactly what happened, and I think Huff thought they called it a shooting foul and didn't realize that they were over the limit, and that's why she's getting the two free throws.
Good point by you, as usual. DeFries hits the second, the lead up to 11 for Delaware. They've grown the lead since halftime by two.
Again, we wanted to see that response, and here it is.
Oh, Collins almost went over and back, spun just in front of the midcourt stripe, throws it across the timeline to Huff, gets it back, attacks off the bouncer, pass tipped, stolen by Gonzalez. She saved it under her own basket, but then a foul is called as Perkins went over the back of Paris McBride, will walk the length, and two free throws coming for Delaware.
And this is enormous because Delaware has been getting to the free throw line. They're getting a lot of these points from the line, and we said that was one of the keys. If they can knock down free throws and free points, that's really going to propel them in the lead. Candace Jackson for College of Charleston, the coach, pleading with her team to grab the basketball. They're getting their hands on it, but they're not able to grab it. And I'm not sure what's going on here, but it looks like they're going to – I'm not sure if they're reviewing or she's calling a timeout.
I think she called a timeout. 3:23 to go, third quarter. They got to cauterize the wound right now and stop the bleeding. I mean, it is it's got to be such a tough counter punch that they have taken. They came out. I mean, this is a team that's 5-12 of the year, 1-5 in conference play. They have freshmen playing at some real key positions, and what a spurt they put on to start the second half. And that's why, I don't know about you, but I could not be more impressed by Delaware absorbing the blow, and then they didn't just counterpunch, they counter haymaker on the way back. I mean, this has been a phenomenal 12-0 spurt from Delaware.
And we mentioned when Jasmine Dickey came in that maybe she could give some life to the offense, but she's actually given life to the defense. She's gotten her hands on the basketball. The one she was playing on the high side tipped it. Abby Gonzalez gets it, throws the long ball to Simone DeFries for the foul. So they're creating offense by their defense, but it's their active hands. Almost every pass is being tipped or bobbled, and that's because of Delaware rotating and playing fundamental on the line, up the line defense.
So 3:23 left in the third. The lead is 11. And now this is where, if you're Candace Jackson, you got to be frustrated. Just call a timeout. You drew something up and your team's on the wrong defense coming out of the timeout. She wanted to repress. They were set up to play half court.
And that's where you remember that these are still 18 to 22-year-old kids.
Tough way to make a living sometimes. As McBride between the circles, giving it near wing to Dickey. Dickey hands it there to DeFries. DeFries dribbles inside the arc, finds Dickey, who seals the defender and banks it in with a righty hook.
Boy, is she coming along with the footwork. Did you see the way she was able to feel the defender on her back and twirl around? Nice job by Dickey.
All while holding position to catch that pass as well. Very, very good stuff for the freshman. High post with it forward, forward spinning towards the bucket, up and under, contorting, couldn't finish. Broughton's follow, and she is fouled. And that is the first team foul of the second half on Delaware. It'll be two free throws for Charleston. But I'm surprised Candace Jackson has been working the Zebras a little harder because, I mean, Delaware has created a lot of these whistles, but certainly they have been tilted towards the hand.
I thought they were going to call that on Dickey, which would have been her first, but they called it on Makeda Nicholas, which is her third foul. So that could definitely come into play here.
Nicholas comes over to discuss it with the officials. Oh, yeah, I just assumed that it was on Dickey. I didn't see Nicholas there in the first free throw. Good for Broughton. She'll get one more. That ends the 14-0 run for Delaware. Lawrence in. Nicholas has to sit down. 2:43 remaining in the third quarter. Delaware trying to follow up their best win of the year with another home victory. And a second free throw, no good. Perkins tipped the rebound off of Dickey, out of bounds. And again, Latrice Perkins making something happen for College of Charleston as they get the ball.
Yeah, I've really been impressed. Again, I don't think a lot of what she's done here today will show up in the stats. I mean, she does have 6 points, but it's been what she's been doing, rebounding, getting hands on the balls, and getting possessions for her team.
She got 3 offensive rebounds in that first half. I think she tipped 2 or 3 more Here's Collins working her way towards the free throw line. Got it to Perkins, who got it inside for Broughton, who missed the bunny. Rebound grab by Lawrence. Outlets it up to McBride. Had to freeze behind the defense, but you see the freshman say, oh, let's slow things up. Now McBride wants to take him off the bounce. Does! Oh, the crossover move, laying it in.
And a big smile by McBride as well.
Oh, what a take. She pulled the string, and then Dickey the steal, but they called a foul. Would they call a foul? Oh, they caught it on Perkins, I believe.
I think so, too, because Dickey had the basketball. She had possession of the basketball. Look at these freshmen. Look at Dickey and McBride leading this team here, getting some emotion, getting some buckets, doing a little bit of everything. It's always fun when they start to really get it, and you know that there's so much potential to grow over the next 4 years.
A tough foul, Christine. The Hens did a great job to get a trap. They reached in and got a steal. There was a little contact, but they let him play. And then immediately on the reach back, there was just a graze of the hand, and they called a foul. You're going to let him play that aggressively on the defensive end as Dickey hits the first free throw. You'll take it if you're Delaware, but that is a tough whistle.
I agree wholeheartedly. I think you got to let him fight for the ball a little bit.
Especially if you're going to let him kind of fight to take it away the first time. Here's Dickey one more. The lead up to 15 for UD. Second free throw, that one wouldn't go, and Collins the board. Collins brings it across the timeline. Backing out near center court, feeds it off to Huff, back to Collins. Collins to Huff into the corner, four, tries to drive baseline, has to back it up. McBride is there. Delaware's defense so strong. Back to four, corner three, no good. Weak side rebound tipped out of bounds by Taylor. One and done for College of Charleston.
And that's one area, you know, consistently the last few games that I've noticed with Delaware, though, is the corners. The baseline three-point shots, they've struggled to get out there on time. Definitely an adjustment that needs to be made.
Dickey, top of the key, handing it right wing. Gonzalez head fakes a three, drives to the paint, kicks it out. McBride, another three. That one wouldn't go. She hit the one earlier, only her fourth made three. That one in rhythm. It looked good out of her hand. Charleston the other way. Collins up top, into the corner, Huff. And Lawrence just won't let her get her shot off. The length of Rebecca Lawrence, cross-court feed, Collins, left wing three, air ball. Lawrence, the rebound, saves it into McBride. Headman pass to DeFreeze, clears the defender, banks it too strong. Dickey the offensive board, Dickey the righty hook, she is fouled. And Delaware just too quick to the loose balls now. We mentioned it was Charleston out hustling the Hens to start the second half. That script is completely flipped here late in this third quarter.
And you see the freshman for College of Charleston, Erin Eady, just kind of drop her shoulders in her head like, my goodness. Hey, I'd feel the same way if I had to guard Jasmine Dickey too, because it is no easy feat.
Well, especially when in transition there, she's nowhere near the play. You're not worried about her. And then she swoops in out of nowhere, and Pogo sticks her way over top of everybody to grab the rebound. And she hits the first free throw.
And again, I think the word of the game is response. We've seen this Delaware team respond each and every quarter to College of Charleston runs.
Gut check as Dickey hits the second free throw. She now leads all Delaware scorers with 13 off the bench. And you have to love her bounce back from last game. Probably played her worst game in a Delaware uniform. And it's been instant energy here today. Four driving to the paint. Bobbled it. Got away with a walk, but missed the runner. Lawrence the rebound. Two on one the other way. Gets it up to DeFreeze. Off to Dickey. And she can't bank it home. Lawrence the offensive rebound. And out to McBride, who will reset.
Good decision, and Mary Wary likes it too. She said, calm down. Loved the coaching out there from Mary Wary in the stands.
The Delaware super fan is Dickey gets it left block and is fouled, and Charleston well over the limit, so two free throws coming. Where'd Lawrence come from on that last offensive rebound?
She's had a great game. Early in the game, she was hitting some outside shots, and then in the second half here, it's been a lot of rebounding and boxing out, just doing a phenomenal job.
Dual citizen. Both British and American. Mom and dad are here today. First free throw is good for Dickey. She'll get one more.
And from what I hear, they make some amazing cookies.
I can actually vouch for that. got in on that on the last bus trip. She brought them for the team. And my goodness, they were good. Second free throw, good for Dickey. Michaela Walker, the assistant coach for Delaware, was already dreaming about those postgame cookies if Delaware could get a win today.
And she said she's only eating one if they win.
Final half minute, hands up 19, and another steal. Freeze taking it away. 3-on-2, leaves it for McBride. Lays it in, plus the foul. Oh, what a run from Delaware, from down 1 to up 21 in this third quarter.
Delaware with 3 players now in double figures, 2 of them freshmen.
A 23-1 spurt from the Hens. Free throw for McBride to try to add to the advantage with 21 seconds to go. She buries it. 62-40, Delaware lead.
Arguably the best game that McBride has played so far in the Hens uniform.
Hop the other way. Charleston, they need a bunch of buckets right now. Collins are hoist the 3 and misses badly. Offensive rebound, Perkins, 5 seconds to go. In the corner, she fires the 3, air ball. Rebound batted, Lawrence hustles it down, and that is the end of the third quarter. A 23-1 run for Delaware, and they're up 22 as we head to the fourth. Take a timeout, back with more in a moment. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV. One run to end the third quarter. They had a 9-point lead at the break. They went down by 1 mid-stage of the third quarter and then exploded, and now are up 22 with the basketball to start the final quarter.
Yeah, 2 things that stick out to me. 33 bench points for this Hens squad and 12 steals. 12 steals so far in 3 quarters.
And 27 of those bench points coming from 2 freshmen.
That's right.
Paramus McBride and Jasmine Dickey. McBride dishes off to Gonzaga, steps inside the arc, straightaway deep 2 wouldn't go. Perkins grabs the rebound for College of Charleston. Here we come the other way. Up top, it's Collins. Collins giving it high post to Perkins. Perkins 15-footer, no good. Good rebound grabbed by McBride, weaves her way out of traffic, brings it across the timeline, dishes off to Gonzalez, thought about the 3, instead gives it short corner Lawrence, around it out with a jumper, and Perkins pulls down the rebound.
And Charleston really trying to get the ball moving. I wouldn't say they're forcing shots, but they're looking to hurry and get some quick buckets.
And then a foul against DeFreeze, who did a nice piece of officiating, tried to sell that it was an offensive foul, even though she had shoved the offensive player to the deck.
Hey, you got to give it a shot, you know?
Can't hurt yourself by trying. 9:18 to go. The lead is 22. The spirits are high right now for Delaware. Inbound goes to Larson near quarter, up top to Huff. Swing it left wing over to Collins. Collins whips it inside. Turnaround jumper. Larson wouldn't go. He hit the side of the backboard. And Lawrence pulls down the rebound.
Yeah, it was good inside action there by College of Charleston. They just didn't knock down the shot.
McBride goes between the legs on the bounce, leaves it off for Dickey and Dickey Wall. Good help defense from Larson. Dickey was going to power up and lay it home, and all of a sudden a big tree came over in Larson.
And then she made the right decision to try to make the pass, but just stuttered before she was able to do so.
Three-quarter court pressure from the Hens. Charleston handles it. Dickey paws it. Huff couldn't get it free, and Huff gives it top of the key to Ford. Ford dishes left wing Collins back to Ford. Straightaway triple short, and DeFreeze pulls down the rebound.
A lot of one and duns here for the Cougars.
Gonzalez in transition, thought about the three, dishes to Lawrence, turnaround jumper, no. And Dickey had position, got knocked down, no call, out of bounds to College of Charleston. Hard game to figure out.
It's been a game of runs. Now here in the fourth quarter, both teams having some trouble finding the bottom of the net, but Rebecca Lawrence getting in a great position, getting some really good looks.
I like that she took that shot. Could have passed it to Dickey, but it would have been a real tough angle. And, you know, it's an eight-footer. She makes that more than she misses it.
Absolutely. And then we see Allison Lewis coming into the game. And I thought she did some good things in the first half, but the crew that was on the floor, you know, just were earning their minutes.
They were phenomenal there. Late stage of the third quarter. Up and down the floor they went. Forward near wing with it for Charleston. Lobs it along the baseline to Broughton. Cross-court feed to Collins. Bounce pass far corner to Taylor. Up top, Perkins. Swing it right wing over to Ford. Crossover. Now a spin to the baseline and got fouled by McBride. A little piece of the wrist. And Ford worked hard to earn that trip to the strike.
And that's the thing. You're making it difficult, but you also don't want to foul the jump shot, you know, 15 feet from the basket either. But good defense. Delaware still maintaining good defense up to that time. It was one and duns. They're still active, still moving well.
Two free throws. First one good for Deja Ford. She'll get one more.
And she's played a nice game here today. She has 7 points, three fouls, picked up a few fouls, but she's been pretty solid.
Second one good. 62-42. Lead down to 20. 8-10 to go.
I think if you're Delaware, you're looking for good offensive sets. Again, you're not taking air out. You're not trying to use the clock, but you're looking for good shots like that one.
How about the pass? Dickey right block to Lawrence for the layup plus the foul.
That's great ball movement. That's what you want to show on film to how do you come down and move the basketball, penetrate, and get everyone involved. Paris McBride passes the ball, gets it to Dickey, who penetrates and hits Lawrence sliding down on the right-hand side.
So Lawrence line left. The lead is up to 22. Can she grow it to 23? No, in and out. And a rebound grabbed by Ford. In the corner, it's a drive for Huff. Banks it too strong. Dickey up in traffic to grab another rebound. Outlets it to McBride. Feeds it into the corner to Gonzalez. Back to Paris. Bounce pass entry to Lawrence. Head fake. Spins back to Gonzalez. Gonzalez in no hurry. Nice, savvy play by the vet to back it up. Now wants to attack off the bounce. Kicks it left wing to McBride into the paint. Leaves it for Lawrence. Back to Gonzalez. Left wing triple short. Broughton the rebound.
Ball movement has been really good for the Hens.
Headman pass. Perkins on the run. Lays it in. Great feed from Darian Huff.
Yeah, that was a great catch. Perkins able to keep the ball high without even taking a step right up.
64-44. 7:10 to go. Gonzalez top of the key. Directing traffic, works towards the right elbow, floats it out far wing to McBride. McBride between the legs of the bounce, edges to the free throw line, kicks it foul line right to Gonzalez, calls for the high screen, gets it, five to shoot, works away to the foul line, pull up jumper, no good. Broughton the rebound, and she'll outlet up to four. Ford finds Collins center of the floor. Collins works her way to the paint, now circles out, gives it near corner to Ford. Ford up top to Perkins, 6:32 to go, Delaware up 20. High post give to Ford. Ford got it blocked by Lawrence, but they called a foul. A lot of ball there from Rebecca.
And I thought Ford kind of lowered her shoulder and really pushed Lawrence out of the way. And I thought Lawrence did a good job in her position, but I guess when she came down with that hand is where they called the foul. And you'll see she kind of shoulders her in, gets a little bit of the arm, but I thought it was pretty good defense. You know, talking about those cookies, Marvy Moore, our wonderful fan, Michaela Walker's mom. She wants one of those cookies, too.
And she's also a UD super fan.
She sure is.
She's going to celebrate with some cookies. She said if Delaware can hang on, first free throw good for Deja Four. It's certainly looking like she's going to be able to break out the Chips Ahoy. 6:29 to go, and it ends up 19. Second free throw, that one's good. And it's 64-46. I just am so impressed by what Delaware was able to do there late stages of the third quarter, considering where this team was just a couple of weeks ago. They do not absorb the blows that Charleston applied to start the second half.
Well, that's what happens. When you get a good victory like they did on Friday, you can build momentum. And then all of a sudden, things seem a little bit easier.
O'Leary has it up top, swings it right wing to Cargo. Cargo gives it to McBride. McBride hands it right wing to Lewis. Lewis tries past the defense, stripped on her way up, though. Nice defense by Broughton as she got the steal, and then a foul in the backcourt as Lewis hand-checking Madison Taylor.
That's a little bit of adding insult to injury there. Okay, you lose the ball. You want to play aggressive defense, which she was doing great with her feet, but don't reach. You don't need the hand reach there. Just play good with your feet. Make it get a little difficult, and then get back down into your half-court defense.
That's a fourth team foul on Delaware, so Charleston going to shoot the final 6 minutes. That's the last thing you want, them scoring points with the clock stopped up 18. Especially for an offense that's struggled over the last 10 minutes. They've scored just 7 points. Driving towards the paint, Ford contorting and fouled again. Two free throws coming as they give the foul to Jasmine Dickey.
And it's a good strategy for Charleston because what else can they do? They can't get Darian Huff open for the three-point shot, so they're trying to force the issue, draw fouls, get to the free throw line, stop the clock, and see if they could somehow chip their way back in. And things get a little crazy sometimes in basketball, but you also have to make the free throws.
Which Ford did not on her first. She'll get one more. Older brother Trey played college ball at Virginia Wesleyan. Ford Jr. has gotten progressively better during the College of Charleston career. Big knee brace on the left leg. Misses both. Dickey the rebound for Delaware. Here come the Hens. Up 18, 5:38 to play. Cargo gives the top of the key to Dickey. Left wing dish to DeFreeze. Into the corner, McBride thought about the three. Thought better. Dishes top of the circle to DeFreeze. DeFreeze pick and roll. Finds Dickey moving to the bucket. Banks it in with a right hand.
She is just so athletic. The way she can contort her body, keep that ball in the air while she's basically getting knocked over, that is strength right there.
It absolutely is. That's a pretty good pass from DeFreeze as well through a lot of traffic. Here's Taylor. Bounce pass right wing to Perkins. Into the corner, Huff. Two bodies on her. Whip it inside to Broughton. Blocked by Dickey. And O'Leary ends up with a loose ball. Outlets it up to McBride, who feeds to Cargo. Back to Paris, and they'll slow it up. McBride hits a high screen from O'Leary, crosses over, keeps the dribble alive, lost it, somehow came out of it for a moment with the ball, and then tied up by Perkins. Arrow gives it back to Charleston. And, you know, Paris McBride does so many things well. The one thing you see that still trickles back into her game, she will dribble the basketball quite a bit sometimes.
And not only dribble it quite a bit, but put it out in front of the defense. And there where you don't want to dribble it to pick it up, there you just have to pick it up.
She has made so many good moves, though, today. You see why she's trying to keep the bounce alive. We have a timeout on the floor.
The rule of three states, things that come in threes are inherently more appealing than those that don't. We couldn't agree more. Three SUVs, one GMC. Ring in the new year with a new GMC. Get 19% below MSRP on these select models in stock. We are professional grade GMC.
Cottage of Charleston by a score of 66-46. Charleston with a basketball, dribbling towards the near wing. Huff in the corner, gets it, fires quick three, wouldn't go. Offensive rebound corralled by Edie. She's stripped, though, by DeFreeze, and Delaware ends up with a basketball.
And here's where Delaware can take their time on offense, work those offensive sets, move the basketball, look for a good shot, wind that clock down a little bit.
DeFreeze off the bounce, working right of the lane, floats it high off the window and through.
Of course, unless you get layups.
Simone DeFreeze with 14. And Delaware is back up 22. Entry feed right block, Edie. Edie spinning on O'Leary. Gets the roll as she sticks it over the front of the rim.
I mean, you think about some of these conference games. Delaware only scored 43 against James Madison, 48 against Towson, 40 against Drexel. Then they go to Hofstra. They score 78. Then you start seeing the points come up on the board. 68 here today.
65 in the last game. And they've scored 60 or more now in four straight ball games.
I don't know if it's causation, but definitely a correlation, my friends.
Oh, who's using the big words now? 60 shoot, DeFreeze spins her way to the paint, leaves it off for O'Leary, lays it in. What a pass from Simone DeFreeze.
That's pretty. That is pretty.
70-48, 3:20 to go. Now spinning her way towards the bucket, forward cross-court feed. Collins open three for the corner, around it out. Offensive board, Edie had it knocked away. Loose on the deck, tie up. Arrow belongs to Delaware.
That's everything going right for the Hens. College of Charleston had many looks from that left corner. And a couple of them went down. Huff hit one, Collins hit one. But other than that, they haven't been able to hit much. So Delaware kind of, daring them to shoot out there. But they've had wide open shots from that left baseline.
3:09 to go, fourth quarter, 70-48. Delaware lead is 22 as Gonzalez brings it into the forecourt for UD. Near wing give to Lewis. Lewis up top, O'Leary. Swing it right wing to Cargo. Cargo up top, Gonzalez. Head fakes a three. Hands it off Lewis. Weaving towards the basket, contorting, and is fouled. Almost got the bucket to go. She will head to the stripe for a pair.
Allison Lewis just does such a nice job of getting to the rim. She twists and turns and slices, and she's able to get there. And then she absorbs the contact and is able to get to the free throw line as well.
2:51 left in the fourth. Delaware's lead is 22 and a chance to grow it as Lewis hits the first. Hens hit the road as they will head to William & Mary on Friday and then down to Elon on Sunday. And after that, another road game the following Sunday against Drexel. So three straight, second free throw good, 72-48. Natasha Adair with this win closing in on number 100 of her career.
Now, Elon went down to Towson and lost by one. They had him. They had him in that game. That was a heartbreaking loss for Elon.
Playing much better. The defending champs. Corner three. Ford can't hit. Weak side rebound. Lawrence up high to get it.
She's really done a nice job on the boards today.
Gonzalez feeds it to Cargo. Back to Abby. No hurry now. Up 24 with 2:24 to go.
Rebecca Lawrence with double-digit rebounds.
And Lawrence will get a trip. No, she will not get a trip to the line. Charleston not over the limit, but the foul comes on the floor. She got great position inside. And fouling out of the ball game, Madison Taylor. So she'll get the full treatment from the Delaware band.
gotta love the UD band. They make sure that the guests of the Bob Carpenter Center know that they're here.
I feel the wrath. Here's Lewis tacking to the bucket. Couldn't make the layup in tight. Rebound was grabbed by Larson. Lewis took it away. Awkward fall, but everybody's all right. And Lewis is fouled.
Just love the hustle of Allison Lewis. She, and by her expression, you can't tell if she's having the game of her life or the worst game of her life. She just hustles. And if the ball doesn't go in, she doesn't get the finish, it doesn't matter. She turns around and tries to make a defensive play. That's what you love out of your players.
Charleston just had another player foul out. Bailey Larson now will get the treatment from the Delaware band. Inbound will come near sideline. Lewis will throw it in. 2:14 to go. The inbound to Gonzalez between the circles. Bounce pass near wing. Lawrence hands it there to Lewis. Lewis works her way to the foul line. Lost the handle. Stolen away. Perkins racing the other direction. One-on-one with Gonzalez. Just threw it at the rim. That didn't work out. Lewis grabs the rebound.
Oh, and Perkins is hurt.
I hate to see that. Maybe that's why she threw it at the rim. and she is stuck behind the play. Surprised they don't blow the whistle here. Now Perkins going to try to limp back into the play. Lawrence hits the jumper.
Yeah, they can't blow the whistle until it's their ball, but she looked like her foot got almost like stuck on the ground, and she probably sprained her ankle.
They can't. If there's no offensive advantage, if they're not imminent to make a play, they've been actually blowing it dead. We saw that a couple weeks ago. And at this point, with a 24-point advantage, now 26 with the made jumper, I don't think they saw Perkins hurt behind the play.
I don't think so either. And I think what happened was when she planted, you know how sometimes you feel like your leg goes into your foot? You know, your ankle goes inside. Yeah. That's what it looked like to me.
Lawrence blocks another jump shot, then saves the ball into O'Leary. Lawrence is turning into Kembe Mutombo out there.
Now she just needs a finger whack.
90 seconds to go. The lead is 26. And Delaware with the ball. Quite a win from the Hens. They were down 39-38. From that point forward, you talk about all Blue Hens, a 36-9 spurt as Lewis couldn't hit a runner in the lane. Out of bounds back to College of Charleston.
I know that she hasn't been able to knock the shots down, but I really do love the way Lewis can get to the rim. Next step, just finish. And the games that she has, what a difference she's made.
She certainly will glide as a layup inside. Broughton got a nice feed from Collins, who gets another dime. And it's 74-50. Final minute of the ballgame. An emphatic performance from the Hens in the second half. This will be one they'll point to for a little while.
Well, this whole weekend, I mean, what a successful weekend for the momentum for this team. Again, to propel them now to go on the road for some winnable ball games.
To face adversity the way they did today, that's something we have not seen from this club yet this year. Lewis, pull-up jumper in and out, brought in the rebound, and Charleston will get one more shot at it. 27 seconds to go, 1 second differential shot in game clock. Collins fires a three from all the way almost back down to Charleston that wouldn't go. And Lawrence grabs a rebound. Delaware can dribble this one out.
Monster game on the boards for Rebecca Lawrence. Phenomenal.
12 rebounds, and Delaware gets a standing ovation for the Bob Carpenter Center faithful, and a deserved one for sure. The Hens end the game on a 36-11 run, and they win it 74-50 as they sweep the weekend action at the Bob Carpenter Center. What a game by UD, as they were up 12-0 and took a 9-point lead into the half. Charleston comes out hustles them, gets every loose ball it felt like to start that third quarter, and then all of a sudden, the Hens just exploded and made play after play, and they did it with a multitude of different players.
And that's the key. It was a total team effort. We talked about the sense of urgency, the approach to the game. Can they show the same energy that they showed on Friday today? Well, they did. And the freshmen, Paris McBride, Jasmine Dickey, Rebecca Lawrence on the glass, Simone DeFries starting off the game, getting it rolling, you know, with her offense. Just phenomenal.
So 74-50, the Delaware victory. And we will join momentarily by our player of the game and the head coach of the Hens, Natasha Adair, as they make their way over here courtside at the Bob. A lot to celebrate, a bunch of happy faces for sure. And they're going to sign autographs after the game. Bob Carpenter Center.